part. Like, seriously, where are our rigs gonna
Okay.
I know, right? I've been trying to bug this week.
Because, you know her in primary school, this girl was, she, snot nose. You know, I wanted to see what she look like now, you know?
Really? What do you mean?
You know how it is, primary school. Snot in the nose, ashy leg, so God. I wanted to see what she looked like now.
I hate you for that. Stop saying that.
She won't admit that part, but that's a different story.
I welcomed him to the church. And that was how we met.
I'm sorry. Was that, he said you welcomed him to the church. So was it just him that you welcomed that day? And then you forgot that every other person?
No, I welcomed everybody. Okay. He was part of them.
But,
and I tried to encourage him.
Okay.
Okay, all right, sir.
Yeah, she welcomed everybody actually. Okay, but okay. I got a special welcome that
there
day.
There you go. Yeah. There you go.
Okay, special welcome.
Babe, don't worry. This is us of God. Let's just say the truth.
Okay.
We went to the same elementary school together. We're in the same school. We're in the same class. And his mom was a teacher, and my mom was a teacher in that same school. Mm-hmm. So his mom and my mom, they were friends. So, but then I don't like him because he was so stubborn. He was a bully pretty much then.
From the day one, I saw this beautiful lady, in the choir, beautiful voice. But, then I was not very serious. I was not ready for the thing, but, noted.
Grandma see me at my grandma's house. So I went to his grandma's house. So, and I saw him. So, we were talking. As soon as I walked inside the, came inside the gate of that compound, and he told me that, I want to marry you. Whoa. I'm thinking in my head that, are you out of your mind? Because number one, he's dark. I don't like dark skinned guys. And another thing was, well, the only thing that actually attracted him to me was his gap. Mm-hmm. I like guys that had the gap in their teeth. That was the only thing. Mm-hmm. Apart from that, I'm like, I don't know.
But he wanted us to travel to Nigeria together. In my head, I'm like, this one wants us to travel to Nigeria together. He has never proposed. And I get to Nigeria. I already had a plan to go and find a bobo. Plan in my mind. No, for real though.
Holy ghost
fire.
Well, I didn't really ask the question. I made a statement. I want to marry you.
Okay.
Of course, she looked at me like I was crazy.
Far and near to get an idea, I asked my cousin, Gugu, and I also asked his brother, YouTube, to help me out. Different ideas.
This is for Janet. Only for Janet.
It has to be a surprise.
Wow.
Of course, it has to be a surprise,
She's like, I remember you from primary school. You're a bully, blah, blah, blah. I said, look, I want to marry you. And I didn't say anything else. So after that, we spoke for a little bit, maybe like 5 more minutes, and then she left.
When the flight has attained its maximum height, that's about 33,000 feet.
Oh, that is so romantic.
Yeah, that's about 33,000 feet. We're gonna ask the pilot to make the announcement and all that. And I'm like, oh, really? Yeah. It's like, oh, yeah, I'm here for it. Like, while I was sitting, something was like, I was feeling very uncomfortable,
Just because of proposal.
What was going through your mind? I want to know what was going,
through my mind.
She'll say no.
That would be one thing.
No, if he had said no, I would probably have jumped out of the way.
God forbid.
Left it alone, came back to America. Mm-hmm. And this was what, in like December, like no, January, right? Mm-hmm. So by mid, is it March? Phone ring in my apartment, then I pick up the phone. Oh, hey, Teju, how you doing? Just chilling. I was back to my life here. And then she said, yes. I said, yes. But I knew, I had to play with her a little bit. I knew what she was talking about. She said, yes. I was like, yes to what? You'll marry me? And then that's pretty much how we started.
It was amazing. Everybody in the aircraft stood up.
That's good.
Great ovation. People we sat almost in the middle. People were sat on the front. So stood up.
Did they move you guys to business class or first class after that?
Oh, please,
no,
girl.
No. They didn't. But
I wish.
We were more like a celebrity on the aircraft. Everybody was like, oh, congratulations.
Even when we got down, people made way for us and we're clapping. It was kind of embarrassing, but nice.
That's good.
I feel like to have have and to hold is
our thing.
It's our red carpet. Because it's our red carpet. Because it seems to me like people don't they don't take it serious.
Right.
Like they just like, you know, it's to have and to hold. Let's just go and sit down and eat jollof rice and fried rice. No, it's to me, I feel like it's more than that because he's really, really impacting.
To have and to hold and Salvation Center, it's a very practical event, you know. I remember moments where we stood up and hugged each other and more or less like
we found our vows
or something like that.
That was nice, very emotional.
It's not just being emotional, it's more than that. Like it's like a rebonding, you know. It's like rebonding ourselves together and all that, you know. There's several moments in that program that I really love and I look forward to having more of it this year, you know. Though we won the cutest couple, you know, we're coming back this year strong.
Okay, not easy.
Coming back this year strong.